everyone.
What's up?
I'm currently on spring break and I am at my grandparents' house and I needed a video to film, so we're back in my grandparents' room. So we're here. I'm wearing jeans, so I have the full-on outfit on today. Don't know why I felt the need to say that. But quick little disclaimer, I am in front of like a big huge sliding glass window. So if the lighting does change, that's because I didn't bring my ring light. Basically, I needed a video to film. I wanted to film a video where I was like helping you guys in a way. Like I want to give you my knowledge. So basically I filmed this Q&A a couple weeks back and I was planning on posting it instead of this video, but I lost half of the footage and it was like a really good video. I was giving like good advice and like blah blah blah, but I lost half of the footage. So I'm here to do a different video for you guys. This was actually my mom's idea, so credit to my mom. I'm so excited. So I asked you guys on Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube to give me your guys' biggest insecurities so I can help you, not solve them, but like help you with them, I guess you could say. I don't know. Little nugget of talking. I am obviously not an expert. I'm obviously 13 years old. I'm not like, you know, I'm not saying that I'm this wise wizard who knows how to fix things. I don't. I just know I've been through a lot and I've cycled through a lot of insecurities. And I've taught myself how to overcome certain things and I want to help you guys, and you know, I know a little bit, so why not share it? So I have so much. I even like wrote down a bunch of stuff. Like, sweetheart, we are all ready for this video. It's gonna be a good video. I have like so many of you guys' insecurities, and I would just like to say insecurities are things that like literally everyone goes through them. Even the most perfect person in your eyes that you think doesn't go through, you know, having insecurities and dealing with being insecure about themselves, even if it's just one thing. And trust me, they do. People are so insecure about themselves. It's just a normal thing for people to do. So just keep that in mind. But everybody has insecurities, and it doesn't honestly have to be about your body or your skin or your hair, you know, your physical appearance, or even like if you're shy or like you think you're too loud or weird. It can be about a lot of different things. You can be insecure about anything. Like, I'm just gonna go through some of mine, and I'm not trying to be like sappy or like weird or like, you know, feel bad for me. This is just my insecurities. But I had a lot, especially last year and kind of the beginning of 2019, I had a lot of body insecurities, and like that's like the typical like type of insecurities you have. But I like, obviously being someone who does have a YouTube channel, I do see a lot of perfect people, you know, with flat stomachs and, you know, toned legs and toned arms and clear skin, and I will get more into that because I have some things to say about that. But basically, I had to realize that my body shape is different than everyone else's, and I mean people do have my body shape, but like I just have my own body shape and I have to accept that. And yeah, I will talk more about me being insecure about my body because a lot of you guys did say a lot of stuff that I've gone through, so yeah.
Okay, hi, so I'm currently editing this video. The more and more I edit it, it sounds like I'm some superwoman and I just I'm like not insecure about myself anymore, which is not true. I still have my own insecurities about, you know, certain things, and it sounds like I've gone through having so many insecurities and I've just gotten over all of them and now I'm some superwoman. That is incorrect. I've gone through a lot of insecurities and I've had a lot of insecurities. I've gotten over certain insecurities, some insecurities that I've just accepted and moved on from, and some I just haven't. And I'm just trying to express that there is a way you can get over your insecurity. So yeah, okay, bye.
So I think generally I'm just gonna start off with one topic that I got a lot from you guys, and it was your bodies. And that's like, when you think of insecurities, you automatically think, oh, my body. I'm insecure about this on my body, you know? And yes, yeah, totally. So I got some of you guys saying that like you feel insecure when you see girls with flat stomachs.
Hey guys, so right now in this video, I'm talking about if you're insecure about not having a flat stomach. And I just wanna make sure that anybody out there who isn't insecure about that, or maybe does have a flat stomach and, you know, does, I just wanna make sure that I'm not making you guys feel bad if you do have a flat stomach, or if you're insecure about it, or like, you know, whatever. If you love it, embrace it. If you don't have a flat stomach and you love that, embrace that. I'm just generally talking to the people that are insecure about that certain thing about their body. So yeah, and if you know, yeah, so don't take it personally. If you have a flat stomach, girl, you embrace it. You wear those crop tops, you wear those swimsuits. Anyway, so yeah,
I totally get it. So do I. Sometimes. I did for a very long time. One thing that I've always kind of been insecure about is my stomach, and I try really hard not to be, and I try to just really not focus on it. But it is kind of hard because it's like you see it so much nowadays, and there's so many people to compare yourself to, especially with the flat stomach. But one thing I've had to realize is that I eat healthy, I work out, you know, I eat generally healthy, I work out sometimes. You know, like I'm not chugging down a bunch of crap into my body. It's just my body. I have rolls when I sit down, and honestly, that's just my me. That's my body. I kind of think, looking back, I've always kind of had that. And you can't focus on it. You can't compare yourself to someone else. And I know that's really hard, and it's like not something you can just stop thinking about and stop being insecure about overnight. You have to focus on something else you love about yourself. And the majority of people out there don't look perfect all the time. But the people who decide to put themselves out there in front of millions of eyes are most likely to have perfect bodies because they are so confident in them. And, you know, and I'm not saying there aren't people out there that aren't, you know, super skinny that don't put themselves out there in front of the internet, but majority of people are, and it's just because they have the confidence. And, you know, even them, they probably have insecurities and about their body, about themselves. You know, it's a matter of how you're gonna take it. I mean, I could look at them and be like, oh, I just wish I had that stomach. I wish I had a flat stomach. I just want a flat stomach. Or I could look at it and think, I love myself. I love my body. And yeah, it would be great, but I don't have one. So I'm gonna focus on something else I love about myself. And even if you don't, like, who cares? I know it's like hard to, it's... Saying, like, who cares is, like, something that you're like, well, I care. You can't care, though. You have to focus on something else. And if you're trying to improve that, and if that's your goal, then that's an amazing goal. Have that goal. But you also have to realize what your body shape is, what your body type is, how you're built is different than the girl you see in the picture with the perfect skinny little body. Just think about that, okay? Okay. And also, like, just, it's everybody struggles with body issues. Everyone. Trust me, I know. You can't look at someone and see what they look like on the outside and just base who they are on that. There's so much stuff to it. There's so many layers to being insecure about your body. And I guess with that is if you want to try and improve it, try and improve it. But when you try to improve it, also take in consideration what your body type is and that everybody is insecure about their body and you just have to focus on something else. Does that make sense? I sure hope so. And then another thing that I just kind of got overall was your guys' skin. And let me tell you, everybody goes through bad skin days, bad skin weeks, bad skin months even, sometimes years. During like Christmas time, up until like maybe like the beginning of March, I had really bad skin. I didn't have a lot of pimples or acne, but when I did get a pimple, it was really bad and it was annoying. And I couldn't seem to keep it under control. But bad skin is caused by so many things. If you have acne, it could be because of genetics or, you know, just how you're built, like internally, like, you know what I'm trying to say? You get it. It could also be caused by what you're eating, how much water you're drinking, and honestly, if you're focusing on it or not. If you focus on that, I have bad acne, I have really bad pimples, that's all you're gonna get, sweetheart, because you just can't focus on that. And there is a very small amount of people who actually have clear skin, and I don't even know how they do that. But I don't have clear skin. It might look like it, but I have like a pimple right here. I'm getting one right here. I have blackheads galore. Like, everybody deals with it. I think I got one of you guys saying that you're insecure about putting makeup over it and people seeing that you have makeup on it. And yes, I definitely hate that, especially when they're crusty and gross. But honestly, what I've learned is people don't pay that much attention to it. Like, if you have a big pimple and it's dried out and it's crusty and it's kind of gross and you put, you know, concealer on it and then it's like all flaky and gross, people don't pay that much attention to you. Like, you might want them to, but they just don't. And if they do see it, they don't really think, oh my gosh, she has a pimple. Like, it's not how it works. So hopefully that makes you feel better. I got some of you guys saying like your like bone structures, like your nose or like your nose. I got a lot of your nose. Noses are weird, okay? Everybody has kind of a weird nose. Noses are weird. They're just weird stuff. Like, what is that? My best advice for that is just focus on something else. Honestly, if there's anything that you just can't really fix, and not saying that any insecurity insecurity needs to be fixed, but if there's something that you physically just can't fix, I mean, I guess you can get a nose job. Embrace it and focus on something else you love about yourself. I think overall, with each and every one of your guys' insecurities that I read, or that you said, or, you know, that you are even thinking about in your mind, or anytime you look in the mirror, I think you have to realize that it's human. It's human to have those insecurities, and just because you have those insecurities doesn't make you a bad person, or shouldn't make you feel bad about yourself because you have those insecurities. And comparing yourself to others is something everyone has done at least once in their life, or is doing, or it's a daily struggle for anyone. Even in your mind, the most perfect person struggles with comparing themselves to someone. Some things you can do to help you overcome those insecurities is write what you love about yourself down. I've said this a lot throughout the video, but focus on what you love about yourself. Like, it's just like writing things down. Once you write that down, you are automatically thinking about it. So keep thinking about it. Try and focus on one thing you love about yourself each day. So like a new thing each day. Another thing is, don't be shy to give yourself compliments. Do not be shy, because I feel like for some reason, this like stigma around giving yourself compliments, I don't see anything wrong with that. That does not make you cocky. That does not make you arrogant. That just makes you understand you love yourself. Another thing you can do is make others feel good about themselves. This will automatically make you feel good about yourself, because even if you just give yourself a goal of like, give 3 people a compliment today, and it can be the slightest thing, like, I like your shoes, I like how you did your hair today. It's just, it makes them feel good, and then it makes you feel good for helping people. So I hope this video was helpful for any of you guys struggling. I know it's kind of hard to just hear me talk and be like, oh yeah, I can do that. I can just forget about what I'm insecure about. That does not happen. It takes time, and it takes work. You can't just say, I'm not gonna be insecure about this anymore. You have to really work at it and make sure you don't let yourself beat up yourself for not being perfect. Like, that doesn't even make sense. Each and every one of you are amazing and deserve so much, because you have this amazing body, you have amazing hair, you just are really amazing. And just tell yourself that and focus on that. So yeah, I love you guys so much, and don't forget, never stop buzzing your own buzz. I'll see you guys next week. Bye.